Good morning, traders. Welcome to today's market review. This is Fred Rezac at CMTrading. Today is October 19th, 2017, and today is Wednesday morning. So looking at the economic events of the day, just two numbers coming out. Not majorly important numbers, but numbers to be aware of. At 10:30 South African time, we have monthly retail sales coming out of the UK. We'll take a look at the GBP. And then at 2:30 South African time, weekly unemployment numbers. So like I said, it's not major numbers that are coming out, but important enough to really keep an eye on if you are in any positions already. So let's look at the markets and see what's been happening. So we're looking here at the EURUSD. We had a decent rally from yesterday morning. And as you can see, we broke above this level of the moving averages right about right here. And that's a nice indicator of a nice buy signal. And, you know, we had about a 40 to 50 pip rally after that. So a decent trade, okay, altogether, if you were able to cash this yesterday morning. And we did mention this, if it does rally above these levels, you know, it may just take it up above. Now, what's nice about it is that it has respected its resistance right here, 1819, and we didn't go above it. So we're trading right now at 1795. Suffice it to say, not really crazy amount of news coming out today. So we'd like to see if this rally was really sustainable. So I'd like to see some sort of confirmation, some sort of hold. You know, I'm not gonna say that we're gonna pass this 1820 level, but I'd like to see this hold today. Okay, that's my goal, to see if it does hold. If it doesn't hold, then it's a nice short, and maybe you could pull out 30 to 40 pips on the trade on the downside. So keep an eye on that as that resolves itself later today. And looking at the GBP USD, okay, similar story. Okay, just not as a strong rally. Okay, so it seems like the GBP has come back to its natural form where it's lagging behind the euro. And you know, we're just trading about this 132-ish level with a resistance of 132.21-ish level. As you can see here, we didn't falter above it. So like I said, let's see if it does sustain itself. I would keep an eye on both the euro and the GBP versus the USD to see which one is going to take it up and which one is going to lead the market in either direction. Looking at the USD ZAR, a nice rally. Okay, this is really hard to catch, okay, because it's been very choppy. You know, up, down, up, down, up, down is not much of a character that a trader can anticipate for their trades. But, you know, altogether, you know, it does trade above this moving average. When it does break above the 30-day moving average, it might be a good indication to jump into it. Now, it's at the 14-day moving average, and if we do see some sustainability and it does rally above, that might be a good indicator to actually buy the dollar versus the Rand. Okay, so you know, the Rand, when it does go up, it means that it's getting weaker versus the dollar. That means there's $1 that could buy more Rand. So, you know, altogether, the dollar has been rallying across the board. Now we're going to look at the USD Japanese yen, and it's a similar story. Okay, 113 here, and we're at the top of this level. Now I wouldn't call it much of a resistance level, but it has had some resistance in the past, you know, going above this 113-ish level altogether and sustaining it. Okay, we've hit it several times, as you can see earlier. Okay, 114-ish, 114-ish, and then this 113, but it hasn't really sustained it. Okay, I don't want to see something like this. Okay, I want to see it sustained. And that's really an easier trade to really, you know, jump in and anticipate, you know, upside momentum. But altogether, it has been a choppy trade. You know, if you've been buying the bottom of this, you know, area 107 and trading the top of this 113, that's been a pretty decent trade. Okay, 700 to 600 pips. You know, there's movement there. Okay, you could play it as a swing trade. You could play it as a longer term trade for taking advantage of that. So, you know, in terms of the USD Japanese yen, okay, a lot of it is based on what's going on in Korea. So, you know, it's a little bit hard to say, you know, a directional move, okay, in one direction or another. Looking at gold, okay, gold is trading 1277, just trickling down. Okay, there's no, you know, there's nothing saying that this is going to start momentum on the upside, momentum on the downside, but it's just trickling down. Now, this is going on the back of, obviously, we've been talking it for a few days already, The Dow Jones, the mighty, mighty Dow Jones, okay, trading at 23,108. Okay, we're above 23,000 and we closed above 23,000. And we're in the winter months, which, you know, October, November, December is traditionally, you know, negative months for the Dow Jones. And we're just, you know, trading up higher and higher, higher every day. This is very reminiscent of 1999. Okay, that's how old I am. You know, it takes me back to then where money was being funneled into the internet stocks, into the online businesses. Amazon was just coming around, Priceline, these type of companies, and money was being funneled into the market. Now, this is the prerequisite to a very volatile market. This is just telling you that, you know, that there's follow through, that there's trend. And especially these kind of prop traders that are trading in the U.S. on a daily basis, okay, they're trading very large volume and they're making 20 to 30 cents, you know, on overnight and, you know, continuational trades, etc. So keep an eye on this as well, okay? There's no point, there's no pullback. We've mentioned that before. The red bars are very few and far between, so it's really hard to jump in, you know, when you feel like you're chasing it. So it's really, you know, again, a very difficult trade because, you know, there's no pullbacks. But at the same time, you know, your trend is your friend until it proves to you otherwise. The DAX finishing above 13,000. That's also very, very important to mention. And you see that, you know, the Dow Jones and the DAX are trading in tandem, like we mentioned before. So keep an eye on them. You know, it's if you do get a pullback and you're able to jump in, you know, good for you. Just keep a tight stop loss. Okay, that's my advice there. Looking at the Johannesburg Stock Exchange rallying back after this, you know, falter below this 14-day average, but we never faltered the 30-day average on a four-hour chart, and you'll see that we've above the 52,000 level. Okay, so if we do not falter above 52,588 and we do make a double top, that might be something of, you know, of concern. So keep an eye on this as well, all right, to make sure that it does rally and this is not a lower high. Otherwise, I don't see why this can't continue going up either. Okay, this is following the rest of the indices around the world, and it's showing that there's no relative weakness here. There's relative strength, and it's, you know, it's trading in tandem. And everybody, it's like those, if you ever saw those ballet dancers in the pool, you know, everything is in tandem. Everybody is, you know, almost so synced to one another, and the markets are being synced. That's exactly my analysis of it, of this recent rally up, okay, because most of the markets are going up together with the Dow Jones and the DAX. So it's showing some economic strength around the world and around the globe. This is Fred Razak. I want to wish you guys a great trading day. Thank you.